Hey everybody, welcome back to my Ninja Gaiden Sigma 1 video guide walkthrough. We're on Chapter 3, The Skies of Vengeance. The difficulty mode is set to Master Ninja mode, the highest difficulty. So I hope this guide's going to be helpful for everybody. And we're taking to the skies here. So you want to go room by room and get each item in this stage. And this is going to be a long video. This is, I believe it's over 30 minutes long. And the reason is because I included the entire fiend challenge of killing 120 enemies in the storeroom. So it's a battle you don't want to not do, because it will net you a lives of the thousand gods. So just go room by room. And in this room over here, you're going to have a fight. So you get the map in this treasure box. And then once you head back, you're going to get a cutscene. And I remarked in my last video, see how this door locks? Maybe the animation wasn't shown there, but the door locks all the time, and I always found it funny to imagine, like, you know, who's behind the door locking the door? What asshole is behind that door, you know, locking these doors on you, trapping you in these battles? So, fall back there. Gonna have a couple enemies coming out of there, and just remember that there's a couple more rooms we need to clear. There's going to be some more items in there. So, new enemies. These are tactical ninjas, and they're very impervious due to their heavy amount of body armor they have. The white guys, they're not hard. They can be pretty much fly swallowed and beheaded with a lot of ease. The enemies that wield the bazookas that are going to be in the storeroom, those guys are not hard either. It's just the guys in the black armor that are have a lot of resiliency and cannot be... they can be Azuna dropped, or they can be... You know, you need to do the helmet splitter on these guys. It's the best move to do. Square, triangle, and then square again. It's not the official way to do it, but you'll get the feeling. This should be your fourth campaign through the game. I mean, unless you're using another person's save data or something, and you know you've unlocked Master Ninja mode. I never liked the fact that you had to beat every difficulty, you know, every single one back to back to back. I never had the tolerance to do that. Play back to back. I would always play something else in between all the victories. But I did. This is my fourth campaign through the game. Probably even more. I have not at this. As I'm speaking, I haven't beat the game. But I am going to. I'm committed to beating it. And it's a full on war, like I said in the previous video. So once all these enemies are cleared, you're going to get an item here. It's the wing key. So now we're going to be able to access this door here. And there's going to be some more enemies over here, so I neglected to save it. And I also grabbed that scroll there just because I wanted it out of the way. Those are all tutorial scrolls, and there's no way to not have them be thrown in the environment. There's just no way to take them off, even though at this point, you know, the fourth campaign so far, there's no, you know, we don't need to see those anymore. These guys need to be slain, obviously. This is the main area here we're going to be backtracking to and saving constantly and buying stuff. The store is down this staircase over here. So it's actually pretty interesting that you can upgrade your dragon sword up to level 2 this early on in the game. So that's always the first thing I do, even if it results in my not being able to buy any more items, which is exactly what happened. But I had a few items on hand. I don't like the HUD in this game. It needs a pause screen when you press the HUD. It just in Ninja Gaiden Sigma 2, that's what they did. It worked perfectly. In this game, when you activate the HUD, it just all the chaos keeps going on around you. It's really bad. So you're forced to doing everything really quickly in the menu in the left bottom corner, or pressing the pause screen, which I have to do sometimes because things get really chaotic. And so this item over here you want to grab. Let's see, what do we have here? Elixir of the Devil Way. All these items are... this looks like some kind of a kitchen over here. So all these items you need to grab because it's going to offset you having to spend so much money over here. So this is the only door that's going to be accessible over here. Don't believe there's any info to pick up there. You get a little cutscene here, and this can kind of be a little hard fight because very poor visibility due to poor camera angles here. So yeah, this is an interesting environment. We're up in the air. I would also recommend having a save data for all of the every single chapter in case you miss something. Especially this chapter here, if there are no life of the gods to miss in this chapter, but there is that one fiend challenge, and it's kind of miss. It's not really. It's called a fiend challenge, but there are no fiends involved. It's just the soldiers, so it's kind of a semantics issue, but it's not a big deal. But the main point I was trying to stress there is that if you beat this level and you overwrite the data, you're not going to be able to come back to this level because this is a non-linear game. But this is one of those stages that you can't obviously cannot come back to because it's in the air. So a lot of items that you miss in the game can be picked up. It's really like Metroid in a way. You could backtrack all over the place at any time you want, but this is one area that you cannot backtrack to. So just bear that in mind. So also get that Golden Scarab off the sill. That's the first one of those we've picked up. Don't worry, I'm going to get all 50 of those. And it's going to be event logs and all my descriptions for these videos. Like I said in the last video, I did skip a door there. That's because it's locked. We're going to have to get a key to open that door. So here's a pretty intense battle. I don't have, at this point in my campaign, I didn't have enough money to buy the scrolls for the counterattacking, so I don't counterattack here simply because I can't do it. Pardon me, one moment. Excuse me. Boy. I don't even think I have the ability to do the Azuna drop at this point. So these guys just fly on into the room, and you got to dispatch them. Do wall jumps off the wall, somersault backwards if you want to, and do UTs, do anything you want. My first run through this game, I had the scrolls for the counterattack, so I will be discussing in length how to counterattack because it's very important to do. And it's something that I'm not perfect at, but I'm fairly good at it. So over here, gonna get some more enemies coming out of this elevator. May only be one enemy. There's more enemies flying onto the sides of the ship. So these guys are pretty tough. When we get to the chapter challenge, there's a couple of enemies, similar, more of these black enemies with the black body armor. Very tough enemies. So you really need to be doing the helmet splitter. And I decided to use a little Nimpo there, just because I got kind of got frustrated with their resiliency. So once these enemies are gone, you are going to be getting a card to access more areas of the ship. Another bad issue about these enemies, a lot of enemies in this game is that they grab you. And I hate the fact that enemies grab you in this game and you can't get free of the grabs. Especially the boss battles. Getting grabbed in a boss battle is so frustrating. And I heard a very good point from somebody. I was watching another person's guide and they're pointing out that this game should implement the fact that if you want to get released from a grab, you should be dropping Nimpo. That is an excellent idea. I really think that would be a great thing to implement in this game because when you get grabbed, there's nothing you can do about it in this game. It's so irritating to the point of, it deals heavy damage to you. In Ninja Gaiden Sigma 2, getting grabbed by a boss on Master Ninja difficulty can result in your death. A one-hit grab death. It's really ridiculous. And I always thought that would be excellent to, drop Nimpo and get released from the grab. It would, you would waste a little bit of Nimpo, and that would kind of be your punishment for having to get, released from a grab, without getting damaged. That would be really good, though. A lot of good ideas I hear from people. A lot of good ideas I think about, to myself, like, there's just a lot of issues. They'll pop up all the time. So I decided to, exchange a... Oh, so he gave us a smoke bomb. So the first golden scarab that you give to this guy, he will give you an item, which is a smoke bomb. I don't use the smoke bombs, although I have seen videos of people use them very strategically to block like projectiles and stuff and prepare charges. I'm not very versed in using the smoke bomb. So over here, another. I apologize for these loading screens, but the game never apologizes to me for them. So over here, there's going to be some enemies after you turn this crank. I would recommend shooting these exploding barrels at the beginning so you don't, like, run into them when you're facing these enemies. And you get, I think you get $100 for every exploding box. So, you do turn the crank handle a couple of times, and then you're going to have some enemies drop in and interrupt you. Turning the crank is just done with the square button. There's no button to tell you. You want to try to behead this guy with the bazooka, and at this point I do have the counterattack, so also the Azuna drop, I have that picked up. I have the skull for that. I will be also I wanted to mention the splash damage of the Azuna drop. Very good when you're coming down off when you're body slamming the enemies onto the ground. So there is that was a counterattack with a square button. But I do like the fact that the Azuna drop does splash damage. Some of the splash damage on the when you're coming down and you're dropping on like one of these foes here with the black armor, they will block it. So it's really bad. These guys are so block savvy, it's ridiculous. See right there that the enemies block the splash damage, and he grabbed me. You just gotta really be careful here. Another guy with a bazooka drops in. Every enemy with a bazooka in this game, they're very, very easy to kill with any move, like a guillotine throw or a beheading. It's just kind of, since they have like such a hard weapon to deal with, the game kind of gives you the little luxury of destroying them with ease. I would say it's very important and necessary to, after that battle, to go back in here and save it, because it's so easy to fall off the rails in the next sequence that you're going to get really irritated. And it happened to me, and the reason you're seeing me go back and save is because I got tired of dying on accident, just falling off. One time I was trying to guillotine throw a guy, and it didn't connect, and I went flying over the rail. It's really bad. They shouldn't let you fall off so easily, so you definitely want to... So when these flying drones appear, you just want to jump and aim at auto-aims. And what I did there is the essence that was inaccessible to me, I absorbed by holding the triangle button. And you get a fraction of the yellow absorbed essence. But the really bad thing is, when you're absorbing essence from afar that you can't reach, and it's blue essence, they should give you a little bit of the health. It makes absolutely no sense that you can absorb essence that's out of your reach for the yellow essence, and you get like a couple of dollars of the essence. But when you're absorbing the blue essence, you get no health. It makes no sense whatsoever. That's another thing I would definitely improve if they ever remade this game. So watch some of the guillotine throw that guy. And since I had a save point, since I saved it, I was had a little luxury of doing that. There's a chest down there that contains bats. If you want to kill them, they're the exploding type. So, if you want to take the risk, they will deal some pretty significant damage to you. But if you're trying to do a karma run or whatever, those are the kind of things that you need to do. I don't take any great store in karma. I don't. If I'm a ninja dog at the end of a level, I don't even give a shit. I don't care if I'm a ninja dog or if I'm a master ninja in my ranking. I just want to clear this game. I want to help other people clear the game. So I destroyed that barrel. That wasn't any grand implementation on my part. I just had a barrel there that was left. Remember, it's very, very easy to fall off these rails, so don't get too... I thought I was going to go flying off right there, to be honest. Thought I was going to go flying off again. But again, it's nice to have that save point to fall back on. And you don't have to do that battle with the turning the crank and whatever. Don't try to go faster on this pole like you can in God of War 2 and 3. You can't press over and X to go faster. This is as fast as you can go. So we're really dangling over some really dangerous situations here in this game. Definitely press down and X to jump off. And then head on back to the save point and grab some more arrows if that's your liking. And head on back into the save point. Just don't fall off the rails. I can't stress how important it is not to fall off. It's so, it's such an issue. Okay, so now I'm gonna head back to the where we spawned originally in that room, and now we're gonna be taking on the fiend challenge. And I'm gonna hit the save point, and you're gonna notice that my items are have. See how everything on the bottom left has 0, and then when I restart it, I have 5 and 2. That's because I had to go in and out of this room a lot of times to get enough items to prepare for this fiend challenge. Because in Ninja Gaiden Sigma on Master Ninja difficulty, you have to slay 120 enemies. And the reason I don't have the kill count up in the karma screen is because once you enter a fiend challenge arena, it has the original count, like the kill count. It doesn't say how many you have left to kill, but it says how many you have killed. And every time you first access the fiend challenge and then leave it and save it, anytime afterwards, it never has the kill counter up again. So that's the reason that it's not, you don't have the karma screen up. I love to see how many I've killed. It's nice to know, you know, your progress. It's another really poor design on this game's part. So you want to stock up on items before this room, because while this is very simple, you see how simple this is, just killing one guy, absorbing essence, and I actually chain a bunch of these attacks one after another. You will have to slay 120 enemies in this room. These guys are simple. These guys are fodder. Very, very easy to kill. They do grab you, though, so you got to be careful. I just chained a bunch of combos here, and I'm trying to get some of my money back. You see where it says I have 2 great spiritual elixirs? That cost me $30,000, so that was a lot of time spending grinding for money. You can grind for money in this room to your heart's desire as much as you want, but once you do kill all the 120 enemies, that's it. They're not going to ever spawn again, so you don't run any real risk of killing all those enemies because it's such an extremely high number of enemies. So once you get enough money, you want to just leave the room and then save it, buy items, and then just come back when you're prepared, because you'll actually exhaust all your items doing this fiend challenge, unless you're very, very good and you know, better than I. But everything starts getting really hectic, really chaotic once the enemies start coming in, and they're stationary enemies with the bazookas, and we get some more really tough guys with the black armor coming in. They come in pretty, I think, once you kill, probably, I would imagine, 60 of these enemies are killed, and then probably that's what I would imagine the rest of the fight starts at. Again, there's no kill counter, which, you know, I wish it was different, but this game has a lot of issues with it. It is a masterpiece. So there's a nice triangle counter. It's an unmitigated masterpiece, but masterpieces are often very flawed. So, and that's kind of what makes them, you know, paradoxical masterpieces. See that splash damage? The splash damage kills these guys instantly. So that's how easy these guys are. So I'm trying to get some red UT kills. When you finish off a red UT, you want to roll away, because that's likely the enemy's going to be right next to you, so you don't want to get grabbed by these enemies. So I've only used one potion, but I pretty much exhaust all my supplies when the really tough battle starts. It really makes you think that this is a really easy challenge at first, but once things start getting hectic, it gets really tough, very tough. And you're going to see me getting really nervous, trying to access my HUD really quickly, and traditionally when I body slam an enemy like that, I rotate the camera around, just for fun. It also does kind of give you an aerial view of what's below, so it's really interesting. It's like a famous move of this whole series, the Izuna drop. I'm not going to speak of Ninja Gaiden 3 because that game is a piece of shit, belongs in the trash can. That's the only thing I'll ever say about that game. This game is really a really good masterpiece. So yeah, this is a lot of enemies, and it's an opportunity to get some of the money back that you had to spend at the store. I think after this fight, actually I pretty much know, I had about 17 grand after. I could have had more money, but I was chaining a lot of attacks. When you absorb essence off of a red UT, or a blue UT for that matter, when you absorb essence for another UT, you don't get as much money as you would get for just collecting the essence. You do get a percentage of the money, but it's kind of like a little commission. They take a little fee off, commission fee, just like in real life, PayPal and shit. Get some splash damage, kill. And that guy took that guy out, took that guy down to Chinatown. So yeah, there must be at least 60 of these foes to kill before we get the guys with the heavy body armor coming in and really giving us a hard time. So yeah, this is not easy. This part is easy, but once the things get once these really tough enemies start dropping in, be in store for a real challenge. All these fiend challenges are very tough. I will be doing probably all but one of the fiend challenges. The only fiend challenge that I really find detestable is the fiend challenge where you have to kill 120 nightmares. Those guys are like little bosses, and that challenge is completely ridiculous. So I probably won't be getting that. The reward for doing that challenge is the Spirit of the Devils. So you can get possibly five Spirit of the Devils. I'll probably end up with four for not having to do that challenge. It's ridiculous. So now things are really getting hectic. I did body slam that guy with an Azuna drop, and I seem to recall like even more fiercer enemies when I was doing this guide my first time, and I was waiting for them to drop in. It seems like they had a little bit more bulk to their bodies, and I guess they were these guys, but try to get the red UTs on these guys because they love to grab you, they love to deal strong damage to you with their attacks. So always just take care of the stationary enemies, because when you get hit by missiles and bazookas, it really takes a lot of your health away. So you definitely want to have the Armlet of the Moon equipped here for some stamina, for hit point stamina here. That was surprising to get all these Azuna drops on these guys here with the black body armor, because normally they resist it. So my charge got broken there. It's just really easy to get flustered here and lose your cool. Try to get the Azuna drops on these guys. The Azuna drop is such an effective move on a lot of enemies in this game. It's just it's insane how good that move works. And I don't think it's cheap to use that move whatsoever. It's a tried and true move. It's as indispensable as blocking is to me, and counterattacking is. So wow, that was now these guys slit your throat. So now I'm gonna start using Nimpo. And I honestly don't know what's better to use, the Art of the Fire Wheels here or the Art of the Inferno. You can't aim with the Art of the Inferno, and that's the reason why I don't like it very much. You can kind of move the camera around a bit to, see like what you're going to kill, but you really can't aim very well. You don't get a choice. It never lets you like lock in on a target. So always just take care of these guys. These guys are very easy to kill, these guys with the bazookas. But, you see, I'm getting trashed here. So any enemy that's stationary, you want to go to them. Priority number one, take care of them. So that was effective right there. I would imagine that the Art of the Inferno is a tad bit better than using the Art of the Fire Wheels here. I really don't know. It's your preference, Got another Azuna drop. So this is, it seems like this is never going to end, but it does end. And just, there's no way in hell I would be doing this unless there was a good prize involved. So the lives of the thousand gods, there are only so many of those in this game, and wow, throat slit again. It's crazy. So gonna always prioritize these guys, and they kind of drop their bazookas sometimes when you're nearing them, so it's kind of interesting. They kind of get scared and start getting into defensive modes. So right there, distributed hit point damage by moving the left analog stick. During the UT, try to do helmet splitter on that guy. I think this may be the last foe, is it? Nice, that was the last foe. And look what we got as a reward, the lives of the thousand gods. So you want to grab that glinting object in the thing there. And there is a golden scarab up here too, so when I use the lives of the thousand gods, excuse me. I will be using the life of the gods when I get 9 of them. Each time I get 9, I'll be using it. So you want to jump on up here, grab the golden scarab, and then I think that may be like the third one. For the golden scarabs, you get a reward from Miramasa at every 5 you give him. Although he does give you one, you notice the first one we gave him gives you one. You also get a reward for turning in 49, and you also get a reward, obviously, for turning in 50. You get the Dark Dragon Blade. So now we're going to be heading on over to the last area of this stage. I don't like the boss whatsoever. I would probably recommend using, for Dynamo, I would recommend using the Dragon's Claw and Tiger's Fang. So, it's a $3,000 upgrade, and I said, what the hell, I'll just do it. It's going to take more damage off of him. Don't buy 5 low potions, because it's going to be one to pick up. Unless, for instance, you don't have any health, you know, buy 5 and then fill up, you'll have 4. But make sure you come to the next area with just 4, because you can only carry 5. That's another thing about this game, you're restricted to carrying fewer items. Not sure if I mentioned that before, may as well mention it now. You can only carry 5 low potions, 2 high potions, and I'm not sure about the Devil's Way elixirs and stuff like that, but it's not as many as obviously hard mode and very hard mode allows you to. The really nice thing though is that you're allowed to carry 2 Talismans of Rebirth, which I was really surprised that you can carry that many in this mode. I honestly thought they would only let you carry 1. When I was playing very hard mode, they let me carry 2 Talismans of Rebirth, and then when I got to Master Ninja mode, I was shocked. They let me carry 2 again. It's crazy, but it's one of those things I'm very, very thankful for, because it's another chance. It's also grab this Golden Scarab up here, and the Talismans of Rebirth, it's just like having another continue, so it's really nice. So over here, there's going to be some more enemies over here. So grab this item. See, there's a low potion I mentioned. I know they're not officially called low potions, but I just kind of call them that out of convenience because they have kind of long names. Couple of foes here. And then once you hit the save point, there are a couple more enemies as well. But if you die on them, it's been my experience that when you respawn, they don't respawn with you. So it's kind of odd. But anyway, Dynamo is he's not easy. I don't like him. I really struggled on him more so than when I first did this guide. But it's another issue where this game could really benefit from putting checkpoints right before a boss battle, just to spare you the hassle of having to go to him every single time. The worst instance is on the final version of Mirai. So there were enemies over here, but I died. Or I wasn't doing well and had to restart or something. Oh, another issue. There's no restart from previous checkpoint. Big issue. I hate that so much. In God of War, it's so easy just to restart from the previous checkpoint. You do want to pull that handle, though, and save it. Because if you're like me, you're probably going to have to do Dynamo a couple times. So every time you die on Dynamo, you will have to start from that save statue and climb this ladder every single time. And unless you save it, you're going to have to pull the crank every single time. So just pull the crank, save it. And the move you need to do on Dynamo is the Gleaming Blade. And I dropped some info there to allow myself a little bit of invulnerability. This guy is very irritating because these enemies never stop spawning his little lackey helpers. And you need to dodge it like a diagonal. And he likes to grab you. You need to rotate the left analog stick 360 degrees from any starting point. I kind of start from the where the 9 o'clock position is and end on... See the amount of damage it does is very, very extreme. So, you get hit a lot, but that flying swallow has a ton of damage to him. And I honestly didn't have enough money to buy the... I was going to use the Armlet of the Sun to expedite this whole battle and deal more damage, but I just did not have enough money here, so... It actually worked out well. This took a lot of attempts because this is not an easy fight. But using the Gleaming Blade move, it does work if you can get that move in. It's kind of hard to get it in, but once you get it in, it's very successful. So, thanks everybody for watching. I really appreciate the support. And this is Big B. I'm over and out.